We talk about food. We talk about music with musical dudes. Finger on the pulse, Snacky Tunes.
Hello and welcome to Snacky Tunes on Heritage Radio Network. I am one half your host, finger on the pulse, Terry Diabolic, sliding into the chair and slipping on the cans is the tank topless DJ, Never Forget. How you doing today?
I'm good.
Great.
My headphones on.
Who was that?
That was
Apache Beat. We have Illy from Apache Beat coming in to talk about the band, Pop Manifesto, and hanging out this summer. I think she might be a little lost in Bushwick, but she'll be here in a little bit. Awesome, that's great. And also later on in the show, we have Audrey Reynolds from ALR Dye talking about organic and homemade dyeing and the processes of that. But first up,
Audrey, it's very nice to meet you.
Thanks.
But first up, we have James Casey from Swallow Magazine, which is a beautiful and award-winning new food magazine that is flourishing in a time when so many things in print are not. James, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thanks.
Thanks for having me.
Of course. So, Swallow just put out its second issue, and can you tell the listeners at home what Swallow Magazine is?
Well, it's a food magazine, but it's not a kind of a food magazine in the conventional sense, I would say. I think it's more of a way to kind of use food to look at culture, or to use pop culture to look at food. So most of our contributors come from outside of the kind of the world of foodism, I guess, and are usually people who are more often associated with the world's kind of art, fashion, and culture. Yeah, and that should be at least a little bit behind that.
Now, the each issue features a different region of the world, and this one was the Siberian region, mostly dealing with like Russia and things like that. Can you talk about your trip to there and traveling across the country in train?
Well, yeah, well, it's actually the issue's name is the Trans-Siberian Issue, which is a bit of a canard. As it's actually using the train from Moscow to Beijing as a way to link up kind of four otherwise unconnected areas. There's Moscow, there's Irkutsk in eastern Siberia, there is Ulaanbaatar in Mongolia, and it's Beijing. So it's using the train as a device to kind of connect those things. So basically, the way it kind of came about was that after having done the first issue, which was entirely based on the Scandinavian region, we were trying to sit around and work out where to go next. And we kind of had a little bit of a writer's block on it and couldn't really find anywhere that we felt was, you know, as exciting as what we wanted to do. So I decided to take a vacation and trying to get some stuff in order in my head. And one of the places I was thinking about going on vacation was taking the actual Trans-Siberian Express to kind of sit in the room for 7 days and think about it. And then after a little bit more kind of mulling it over, it seemed like that would actually be quite an exciting issue in itself.
Now, you know, reading the magazine, which has beautiful art and really great layout, I was surprised by how deep Russian culture is tied with their food. And, you know, a lot of times when you think of Russian culture, you just think of just vodka and just like, you know, caviar. But it goes a lot deeper than that. Can you talk about some of the exciting things that you found on your trip?
Yeah, I mean, I think first off, I think, you know, that's part of what we try and do is I think every culture is pretty, you know, their food runs pretty deep. I think food for every culture, it's a pretty relevant thing. It's one of the things that we all have to do. But, you know, as for Russian food, there's a little bit of a special part of my soul that's kind of devoted to Northern European food.
Right.
And, there are everything from smoked fish to cured meats and things like that. I mean, it's kind of got it all in that respect. And then the markets when you go there, the amount of produce that you have in season at least, and also out of season, is quite remarkable because a lot of things come from former Soviet republics. So you've got places, you've got tomatoes that come from down in the Crimean. You've got Azerbaijani tomatoes. You've got cucumbers that come from from the former Stan. So the actual produce available to you in certain markets around Russia, or especially in Moscow, is it's pretty remarkable. And their access to cold waters for fish and things like that is also pretty remarkable. So they do have a lot on offer over there.
Anything that was not remarkable, or anything that you got into that was more like a peasant food or like a country type of food that was just outright unedible?
Oh, I mean, that country is just full of things that are also inedible at the same time. I mean, there's a lot of kind of questionable, objects of questionable taste. Like, sushi there is usually eaten with mayonnaise. There are lots of things that, and I think things like pickled herring are not to everyone's taste, but, for the most part, Russian food, as much of a calorie bomb, kind of caloric culture of food that it is, it's fairly tasty. I mean,
Now, one of the interesting articles that I really thought was about the molecular gastronomist chef whose restaurant ultimately failed in Russia. And it sort of talks about how, as Russia is becoming a modern country, there's still some culinary trends that haven't adapted over there. And what did you find else didn't adapt that had adapted in places like America, like the UK?
Well, it hasn't actually failed. It's still in business, and I think he actually does fairly well, but I think his experiment to kind of attract Russians to his restaurant had failed.
Yes, I'm sorry, that's what I meant. I'm sorry, yes.
In the sense that 80%, he says, or 70% of his customers are actually foreigners who've heard about him from overseas. So, I mean, I think perhaps why his experiment hasn't worked on local Muscovites is, there are several reasons. Obviously, it's extremely expensive, his restaurant. You end up spending around $400 a person on a tasting menu, which, whilst there are a lot of oil barons and oligarchs there who could probably afford that, the average Muscovite isn't going to be spending that much money on their food. And secondly, I think, to sit down and appreciate a meal like that, at least as far as he's concerned, he says that we require a certain intellect and education to experience that food, which might be, you know, his own kind of hubristic way of, you know, of kind of explaining why he's not been popular with Russians. But I think to some degree that's true. And I think, you know, generally people in Moscow, I mean, they've come a long way in such a short amount of time, but generally people still want to eat comfort food and things like that. People don't want to spend a lot of money on something that's potentially challenging. And that's, I think, the case, you know, all around. I would imagine, you know, places like WD-50 in New York or Alinea or even, you know, Fat Duck or El Bulli, if those were opening up in, you know, in places like Detroit, there might not be such a market for them.
Right. And so, James, what is the future of the of Swallow magazine? What have you figured out where you're going next, or is that still a secret?
No, next we're going to go to Mexico. I'm actually planning that right now, and we're working, a big team of writers are kind of getting on stuff. So I'm going to start doing some recon missions over the next couple of weeks, and then hopefully we should expect the next issue to be out, if not by Christmas time, just after in the winter.
Fantastic. So if I wanted more information about Swallow magazine, where could I track down a copy, or where can I go online?
If you're in New York, there are a bunch of places that carry us, but the best place to go is go onto our website, which is swallowmagazine.com, and there should be a list of stockists there, and that can kind of lead you to all the places that were stocked, not just here in the city, but also countrywide and worldwide.
All right, well, James, thank you very much. Congratulations on all your success and your two D and AD awards for design and photography for the magazine.
Thank you.
Now that was just James Casey, creator of Swallow Magazine, based right out of here in New York. Thanks so much.
Thanks. Pleasure.
All right.
Great interview.
Great magazine.
Yeah, sounds awesome. Pick it up.
Yep. So we got Audrey Reynolds coming up from ALR Dying next, and we got a song that DJ Never Forget's going to be dropping for us. But first, a big shout out to Roberta's for the delicious pizza and salad. Big shout out to our mascot Sadie, and thank you to Fairway Markets, who's been bringing great produce and fine foods to New York and the outer boroughs for years and years. If you want a great date spot, really no greater place is the Fairway Market in Red Hook. Go out, look at the water, eat some fresh food. We're finger on the pulse, still recovering from the pool party from yesterday. What a crazy time. DJ Never Forget, take it away. Welcome back to Snacky Tunes. I'm Terry Diabolic, hanging out with DJ Never Forget. We're finger on the pulse. That was just Uffy featuring Pharrell, ADD SUV, the Armand Van Helden remix. Summer staple. Only with only about 3 weeks to go, I'm going to put it.
Summer staple we found last week.
Hey, man. You know, with the way that these summers go in New York, you know it's going to last to like at least September or October.
Sweet. Tank tops forever.
Tank tops forever. So we are joined by the wonderful Audrey Louise Reynolds from ALR Die. Audrey, welcome to Snacky Tunes.
Thanks for having me.
So Audrey does dyeing and makes prints and things like that from all organic materials. Audrey, can you talk to us a little bit about your process and your whole philosophy?
Yeah, well, I wanted to start by trying to be a little more eco-friendly. I have a CSA in Red Hook, and I started picking up all the extra, like, broken beets and different veggies, and started making dyes from that and kind of using them for paints, putting them in foods, and also dyeing clothes for fashion.
So where are some of your work and where has some of your products been seen and sold?
I've collaborated with lines like Bodkin, Rogan, Number 6 Store, Samantha Pleat, and various other people. And then I also put out stuff just by my own name.
Yeah. Now, with I know there's a lot of trade secrets, but and not getting too much into Behind the Magic, what's some of the process of extracting colors and dyes from natural products?
Well, you basically... can blend up anything and put it in water and get a color out of it. So whatever color you see, if you want to try and get that color out of it, I would say go for it. Like so beets, these, berries,
these
veggies,
plants outside,
grass.
You can make me like a green, green
totally.
Shirt.
Totally. I'd probably come out like kind of brown green, but it would be good.
I want all green.
Yeah, well then go dive in some grass. Get the streaks.
Deal. What are some of your favorite colors or produce or vegetables to work with?
Well, I have to say I really like using things that I just can find or like around the neighborhood or like if I'm just walking around. So lamb's quarter is a good one. It's also like something that's edible that you can like find on like a walk and steam and eat. But it makes a really good like green brown color. I like using beets a lot. They're really easy to work with. Peaches, roses, indigo.
Is there something for the fruits you use that, like, specifically make out of, like, a color for a shirt or a dress or something like that? Or is it, like, mix and match whatever you want?
Yeah, pretty much. Mix and match whatever you want. When I, like, have a new client, I basically go up to them and say, here's a huge list of, like, different ingredients. Like, what do you want to use? Some people pick, like, chocolate or, you know.
What's the, like, most out there plant that you've used to make something for?
That's a good one. Oh, I use squid ink.
Oh, whoa.
That's not a plant, but that was the most bizarre dye that I probably...
Really black?
Yeah.
That's really... What did you make with it?
It was for this group of cooks, and they all wanted like these t-shirts dyed with it.
Huh, rad. Now, do you grow any of your own materials for dyeing?
I'm trying to. I'm not really yet.
Your green thumb is still a little white.
It's black.
Now, you've also worked in dyeing foods, right?
Yeah.
What have you done with food dyes?
Like icings for cakes and like different food colorings that you can just put in. It's hard to get the taste to come away, so it's often like, you know, the berries are going to influence like the flavor in the cake and things like that. So that's something I'm still really working on.
Now, any tips or any suggestions if someone wanted to start doing their own dye company?
No, because I don't want them to compete with me.
Awesome. And where can we find some of your work? Where can we get in touch with you?
You can look at my website, which is under construction right now. It's going to be back up soon. It's alrdying.com. That's D-Y-E-I-N-G. And go to Number 6 Store and pick up some stuff. I'm always happy to do a custom order, so you can find me on my website and just email me. If you have an idea for something that you want, I'll make it.
Awesome. All right. Well, Audrey Reynolds, thank you so much from ALR Die.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Of course. We are Snacky Tunes on heritageradionetwork.com. DJ Never Forgets about to drop a tiny set, little preview of the Punches sets that were yesterday. We are sweating and eating pizza, and it is fantastic. And a big shout out to Fairway for being our sponsor. Take it away, Never Forget.
Oh,
That song's a heater. Midnight Magic, Beam Me Up, played an awesome show this weekend at Tandem. Really, one
Jack Renault remix, who actually will be on Snacky Tunes next week.
Their show was hands down one of the best shows I've seen in a long, long time.
Yeah, they were amazing. It's half the Hercules and Love Affair Live band and two of the dudes from Jessica Six, and just, it's really amazing.
It's really amazing. What was also amazing is that in Tandem, it was really small, and I didn't know that there were horn players there, and all of a sudden, the horns kicked in the second song, and I was like, that's a really good synth sample. But no, it was actual horns.
Yeah.
So we're just setting up. How you doing?
We're going to interview you.
Oh, now?
Yeah, pull that microphone closer. We got to let people know who they're going to be listening to.
Hello, I'm Ilirjana.
And you are from Apache Beat Pop Manifesto.
Yes, I am.
Galabout Town,
indeed.
Welcome to Snacky Tunes.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. We actually played one of your songs early on in the show.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, Tropics?
Yes.
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 I just
quizzed you. That is one of our songs. Yes. It's true.
So how's your summer been? What you been up to?
A lot of writing, a lot of eating, a lot of like sleeping and complaining about the weather.
So like the heat in here?
Yeah, it's pretty hot in here, people.
Yeah, it's a shipping container does not breathe.
No.
I'm a big fan of Pop Manifesto.
Thank you.
Why don't you tell people what that is?
It's an online magazine I started a little while ago, and it's basically I just do stories on people and things, and like from music to art to design, things that I'm interested in and things that I think that people should know about. And I originally started it because I knew a lot of people doing stuff that no one was writing about. Mm-hmm. And I thought, if I know these people, I may as well like help support them and do something on them.
What's one thing that our listeners should know about that was recently on the site?
I guess like Romy from XX, seeing they just played, did a, we decided to do a mixtape, and she did our first mixtape.
Oh, awesome.
And it's really cool. It's very chill. And
no kidding.
And shockingly.
Shocking. And what is the website so people can download it right is after they listen to this?
thepopmanifesto.com.
Not gonna be able to remember that. Is there a hyphen?
Nope, it's one word.
And also, I think the first time that I ever like met you was at in your Apache Beat show. I believe it was the I Am Sound
showcase. Oh, the showcase, yeah.
Back at CMJ, which was actually an unbelievable lineup that
night. Yeah,
that was super fun, too.
Yeah, I think that was the first CMJ event I've ever like shown up at 9 and left at 4, because every band was
Everyone was awesome. The band's like, it was like a band called Golden Silvers who I'd never seen, and they were really good, too.
Yeah, they were great. Yeah. So how long have you been in Apache Beat?
Well, I started it with the guitarist maybe 3.5 years ago, and we've been like casually playing until like last year, and then we started writing our album, and it comes out in October 5th.
Amazing. And it's going to be on I Am Sound?
It's varying labels.
Oh.
Paul, like, manages us.
Who was a past guest on Snacky Tunes, actually.
Oh, really? Awesome. Yeah. Cool
we
dude.
Love Paul, yeah. And so what are the varying... How's it coming out on varying labels?
Us, because we own it.
Oh.
We own and recorded it ourselves.
Oh. Yeah. Wow. How very modern.
I know. Well, I always think that's an advantage of... You don't have to... You can license and sell it to other people. And
right.
You can do whatever you want with it.
Yeah. You could sit on it and not release it.
Yeah, you can never... Or you could release it and then release something else immediately afterwards.
Right,
it's
exactly.
Like, if you're over it already.
But so we're going to have you DJ a little bit.
Yeah, can it's we, DJ. Let's
see. I mean, we're quoted. We're going to have to play some tunes. But yeah, why don't you step on up there?
Okay.
Okay.
Hopefully everything works.
I'm sure it'll be fine. You're listening to Snacky Tunes on heritageradionetwork.com. If you'd like to hear the episode that Paul Tao is in, you can go to iTunes and search the podcast
you
for
should.
Snacky Tunes.
He's awesome.
He is awesome. And big shout out to Roberta's, Jack Inslee, and Rec Tech. Here we go.
Okay. 4, 3, 2, 1. I love you, like never before.
stitching face to feel what's going on inside. Nowhere to run, well, there ain't nowhere to hide. So I say, I got two arms ready and open, just waiting for you whenever you want to. Come here, come close, this love will grow, cause I've got everything you need. I've been afraid to break it free. With limited fears,
I try to fling, but it's time to show I'm not playing. Be on my back, wanna chat, but I know what they're saying. See, then I know about me, lyrically, the baby, young lady. Come for set the MIC on fire. Take the ravers, them, I am at the evil. Fear you never be like demon. I didn't dare to see lyrical ability to put them 6 foot D double EP. Test me, I'll take you to your final destiny. I got a tongue like a trigger, make them run like river bomb squad. Them, I shiver with my bomb. Deliver anyone a test, I'm a barrier. Did your mother never tell you, not play with fire? Instant them, foot them, wanna be player. Instant them, foot them, envy a slayer. Like they was town crier, to be like the answer, solid is their desire. But they don't know how I spit, and they don't know that I won't quit. I put a stop to their bullshit, make them prank like when shop get lit. And they don't know I got deep, don't see that them bad mind only make me more determined to succeed. Dynamite, so solid, set fuck the envy.
They don't know about my crew, they don't know what I do, they don't know about my flow, they don't know where I go.
There's no need for fighting, there needs to be uniting. Can't you see we're fighting for no reason inside? Are you red or like a
than this? Yeah, I'm talking about back in the day when I never had shit, never roll with my clip. And I never be rolling around with my hand on my stick, now I'm busting them quick. Guns in my hits, and my clips are lyrics, and I'm touching the tits. Cause I'm frozen from head to toe, racing Cartier baguettes, and I'm feeling the shit. Cause I've been there for a day, and I know that I'm reeling the shit. Are you lyrically fit? Challenge me right now, on the stage, with a mic in your hand, to a beat you can pick. And shit, these never fading away, and my flow is too sick, and I keep a full clip. Waiting to exhale on the niggas that got all the lick. So mind when you trip, when you feel that you're tripping, it's me that is making you trip. Keep your mind in the shit. When I tell you to jump, you jump until I say to sit.
Yeah, you think you're up, lad. Me phone him backstage, share him something. Now listen.
Are you Ash? What?
Yeah, when I jump into my tea, I style when people see me. Think again, can they really see me? Don't chat shit, cause I can see you, but you can't see me. I wanna feel merry, but I feel like I can't feel in my belly. No sex, no merch, no smelly. Always a drop, come bound, January. It's getting messy, you better wait for the next bar. Mega man get too dark, so dark. Mega man get high dark, you dark. When nigga man talk, then you talk. We talk, but my name's Mega Man. Listen, Mega can't talk, but talk that they talk. Prepare for get dark, are you ready to get cursed? I froze, but yeah, my shadow would change words. Listen, I said shadow, should I fuck that bitch? He said no, Mega Man, keep an eye on your shit. And I said shadow, can I kill that man? He said no, Mega Man, don't you understand?
There's no need for fighting, there needs to be uniting. Can't you see we're fighting for no reason inside? Are you ready like a
take you out, obviously, but I'm starting to think that you're hating me, cause my head is hot and my hands itchy, and I don't like the smell of PhD.
Don't send a picture now, I'm getting sick now. When you was broke, you know that I bought ya like a bitch in the corner, scoping me out, you know that I taught ya.
Selling my flow, I'm the star of the show. When you're out taking boogies, I'll be slamming it all like storm damage, I'm out the window. No trace when I dust when I go.
I don't give a shit, so check that. Everything you see, you never know, make a wreck that. You bust mine, I bust yours, that's order. So when you're out, take a deep look at your daughter.
Mega, are you a friend or an enemy? Execution is a tendency in my vocabulary. Are you feeling me? I take it to ice that you never will see.
I should deem, stick to reality. Who was you shooting for?
Hey, Mega,
see. Who got your bookings?
But Mega,
see. So who made you dope?
Listen, Mega,
see. You thinking you would have made it without me? Then you're getting too brave competing with me. I should deem, you're diminished. Come dynamite, that's right. Now homie, you're finished.
Step to the mic, the place explode like dynamite. I got the flow, gonna love, gonna like. Kill him all about, cause I'm cold like ice. And when I step to the mic, the place explode like dynamite. I got the flow, gonna love, gonna like. Kill him all about, cause I'm cold like ice. I can get utter, live his papa. Come like a class A shutter. Think they smart,
bottom. Smart talk one like them dark bottom. Dark hard time to get dark, dark like dark vader. Time to make it shake it, watch your mama gave ya. Wipe come like poisonous vapor. Dreading this medical to no escaper. I rock you up like my Amidon. Me and your son in Luston, but won't see round free. When my force deliver, fall like you're dying. Lyrics known to leave gunman crying. So you're brave and say you want some. It's my one to one, you better call your mama. Tell her to build the undertaker, cause I'm sending you back to your maker.
They don't know about my crew, they don't know what I do. They don't know about my flow, they don't know where I go. They don't know about my click, and they don't know about my shit. But they wanna know about my dough, but I don't spend it, I let it grow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Awesome.
I think my ears went the gauntlet.
We actually just blacked out the windows and put on some red lights and
we're ready for the rave right now.
Is it 2 in the morning or I don't know what's happening.
Or is it 2 in the afternoon from last night?
I think it could be either.
Yeah. What was that last song?
It was a re-edit from Kingdom for this like grime rapper from London called Nolay. She's awesome. You should check her out. But yeah, I think this is a excellent re-edit.
And you said that we might be able to see you drop that live.
Yeah.
When?
Yeah, I'm dropping that live. Yeah. I'm DJing.
Take confidence.
I'm DJing Ghetto Gothic in 2 weeks, which is a party at Gallery Bar.
Amazing.
It should be awesome.
Well, thank you for joining us today.
Of course.
You can check out Pop Manifesto at popmanifesto.com, and you can also check out Apache Beat at myspace.com/ApacheBeat. What's the last song you're going to play for us today?
Let me see. It's Embrace Me by Hannah Lindston, and it's a Crazy Cousins remix.
Oh, love Crazy Cousins.
Me too. They're awesome.
Well, you've been listening to Snacky Tunes. Big shout out to Roberta's, Jack Inslee, Rec Tech. Who's our sponsor today?
Fairway.
Throw it up. Next week, we'll be back with Jacques Renault.
And some ice cream delicious treats. We got a surprise guest coming up. We're locking in the final details, but
invite me back for the ice cream.
Ice cream and pizza.
Here's a hint. It's the most expensive pint of ice cream in existence.
Well, this equates to me coming
back. Yeah.
Or at least so sitting outside.
We'll be here next week and every week finishing off pizza and
ice cream.
And
big shout out to James Casey and Audrey Reynolds. Thank you for being our delicious food guests. And
Sadie for lying there like the dog she is. Thanks for listening to Snacky Tunes. We'll be back next week.
Drop it.
Through the night, I can whine and I can grind. Put your front on my behind. I just wanna do you right. Do you right, do you right. I just wanna do you right. Do you right, do you right. I'm your guidance, I'm your light. Let me guide you through the night. I can whine and I can grind. Put your front on my behind. I just wanna do you right. Do you right, do you right. I just wanna do you right. I just wanna do you right.
Your wife. I just wanna do you right. Do you right. It's plain to see, so baby. embrace me, say, oh.